been through so much as a group, okay? From the time you guys walked in to this moment now, we've been through it, okay? Highs, extreme highs, tough lows, okay? The best part about it is you control what's gonna happen tonight, okay? You get to control the narrative, okay? You get to finish your story tonight, okay? This game matters, right? We don't get a state championship at Yakima this year, okay? But we do get a chance to redeem ourselves tonight, all right? Let's go get it.
It is unfortunate, but it is true that this virus is going to spread. Today, my first order will close all K through 12 public and private schools in every district across the state of Washington.
Scouts and watching film and all this kind of stuff. We're gonna watch a couple clips here before we get on the floor. But more than anything, boys, okay, tomorrow you need to make sure you play with your hair on fire, right? It's one of those games where you can't come out casually or you get blown out. Plain and simple, okay? We're better than them. We are a better team than them, okay? And they're not in a place right now where they really feel like they're challenged. I feel like we always kind of have a chip on our shoulder where we feel like we're challenged, okay, which is good, okay? It's when you rest and when you're kind of in that situation where you're trying to like we're in the semis, we're kind of like, oh, I'm protecting something. We're not protecting anything, okay? You're going to go take something, all right? And that's got to be your mentality going into the game, okay? All right, a couple clips. And most importantly, fellas, okay? This is a rivalry game now at this point, okay? Right, it's time to step up to the plate and let them know who the f*** we are, okay? Let's go get it done.
Let's go! SL 3506, 1, 2, 3, SL 3506, man!
We'll be right back.
They're going to reload. We're going to reload. Okay? It is what it is. Okay? But here's the most important thing, right? And I know a bunch of us, right, have had to weight on our shoulders ever since we played them last, right? It's nice to get that shit off your back, right? Okay, so you can celebrate it right now, but that's the last time you can celebrate. Good?
Yes, let's go. Let's go.
Well, I think it goes back to the culture that's been set by, again, those seniors that have been here in the program for 4 years. People forget that they started their careers at SAS 1-11 in their first 12 games. So to have building blocks in place and people who have kind of seen the low end of everything and to be on such a high like we were last year and are continuing to be this year, it starts with them. And then across the board, I think this is one of the more skilled teams that we've had 1-11 in our program. I mean, it was tough on everybody, obviously, being one bucket away from being in the state championship game to really grinding back and getting back to normal, and then having to wait and not knowing if there's going to be a season had to be tough on everybody. But we had a mature group that came back this year and was ready to go and stayed ready and focused. And I think that's a testament to our senior leadership, who've been on our squad since our freshman year. It's a unique kind of season, obviously, but at no point were these kids not ready to play. And I think that's a testament, like I said, to the kind of the program that they've contributed to.
Here's the truth, okay? You get another half, okay? And if we don't take care of business tonight, okay, you better believe we're gonna probably end up having to play over there for tournament time. So this is a big one, fellas, okay? So if you needed a little extra motivation, I was gonna say to you about that, okay? But that's the truth. We don't own the tiebreaker, okay? You need this one, right? This isn't one we can just casually just go through, okay? You need to win the ball game, right? Or else we're playing for a ship at their place, okay? Get that through your heads, get it solid, okay? Coaches.
Yo, you guys gotta bring it, okay? The effort, the intensity, the energy, the focus is not where it was when we were at their place. Do you guys all recognize that, right? So it's time to step up, get it together, right? Let's take care of business, okay? We're right there, right? It's gonna go our way, right? I know they're not getting a ton of calls. It is what it is. Play through it, play together, but we gotta play harder and smarter, and guys gotta step up, okay? And I tell you right now, if you're not stepping up, you're sitting down, period, point blank. Everybody understand?
Just tell me. Let's get it. Come on. Car half. Sass on 3. 1, 2, 3. Sass. Yeah. Yeah.
to get a bucket, okay? Right? That's what it's about right now. That's the next focus. Respond as you come back the next day ready to work, okay? Boys, a mark of a great program, okay? We are a great program. It's not about what happens to us. It's not about what happens to us, okay? It's about what we do, okay, when things don't go our way, okay? Let everyone understand that, all right? And that's going to be the same thing for you guys moving forward when you're not playing in this program, okay? It's about what you do when things don't go your way, right? That defines who you are and who you are, okay? Good? Let's go. Get in here.
Come on. S down 3, count me on 6. 1, 2, 3.
That's it.
4, 5, 6, 9.
I coach. And I lead the program because I want to help develop young men and I want to help them grow. And whatever the journey is, if that's a third place finish, if that's a COVID season, whatever it is, my job is not to focus on the results. My job is to focus on the process and to focus on the boys as individuals, you know, and how I can help them as basketball players and as people. I don't think this group defines them, their success by a win or a loss, or being unable to win a state title. I don't think that they define their experience that way. I think that they're competitors and they want that, you know, but I think that they truly have taken, you know, to heart what we preach here, which is the most important thing is the relationship with each other, right? That you have brothers that you're playing with, that years from now when like you can't play, you're coming back and those are the guys you always know you can count on. You know, that was always, as a player, that was always, you know, looking back on it. That I don't remember the games I won. You know, I don't remember the games I lost. I couldn't tell you how many high school games I won or lost. I don't know. But I can tell you where a bunch of my high school teammates are and, you know, how many kids they have and where they're living and how they're doing. I can tell you those things. And I think that that is something that this group, years from now, is going to look back and that's the part where I think that they're going to find their value. At least I hope so.
It's what happened, you make shit this time. We'll be right back.
right? Tomorrow is like, that's what you live for as a ball player, right? Is these games, okay? All right, you live for it, man. So make sure you guys just take a moment to appreciate it when you're in it, okay? Appreciate the lead up, okay? Appreciate the vibe and the feelings, right? All that kind of stuff is something that as a ball player, you can't ask for a better situation, right? You can't ask for a better game to go play in, right? Okay, I'm psyched for you guys, okay? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to sleep tonight. All right, good? Let's go, boys.
SAM 3 FML 6, 1, 2, 3, SAM 4, 5, 6, 10.
Yeah, I think, you know, goals for this season were just to kind of finish what we started, right? Whatever that looked like, whatever opportunities we were going to have to compete, we want to make sure that, you know, particularly for this group of seniors who has meant so much to our program and our community, that we send them off the right way and put our best foot forward. But also looking ahead, right? Like, there are kids now who are looking at coming to Seattle Academy because they want to be a part of our basketball program. Right, and I don't think that was always the case, right? Might have been one or two kids here and there, but you know, we're really excited about the future of the program, the kids who are excited about it, the families, and so, you know, one of our goals was to make sure, regardless of what we were playing for, who we were playing, that we continued to move the needle and establish ourselves as, you know, a kind of perennial contender, you know, knowing that we're gonna have a squad that's gonna compete at a high level every single year. And, you know, I think that our seniors have really embraced that. You know, I think the younger guys understand what it means to the older guys to kind of, you know, put their best foot forward. And so hopefully we are able to continue to do that, you know, throughout the rest of the season and into the future. You know, at this point, you know, we're not playing for a gold ball, but we're also playing for, you know, the legacy that this group has kind of built, the foundation, and also just, you know, wanting to continue to elevate the program to new heights.
About is, can we lock in and focus and get stops, okay? Consecutive stops, all right? Good? Hey, great half. Let's go finish the story, fellas. Let's go. Come on, man.
Let's go. Win on three. 1, 2, 3, win. Man.
Out!
we're sitting in here playing them because they beat us on a half court shot, right? Okay, and rather than hold, okay, or point fingers or get upset, okay, you responded, okay? And as you guys move forward, right, when you're done with the program, okay, if you remember one thing, okay, remember that you guys have been through it, okay? And you found a way to get on the other side and be all right, okay? And that transcends basketball, okay? Remember this, okay? I told you from the get-go, you're not always gonna remember every single game that you're playing, but you're always gonna remember each other, okay? But you're gonna remember this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, baby.
You're gonna remember 20 pieces of them in a state championship game, right? Nobody was allowed to go play a state championship game. Okay, this is as close as you're gonna get to it, right? Next week we get to play in a cool little tournament. Should be fun. Hopefully it has a good state feel. Okay, but this is one, right? Take your time and make sure you appreciate it, man. It's a big time. Okay, try to.
Unfortunately, Leo went down with a quick ankle injury today. Happened very fast. Just trying to work on a few things to get ready for the tournament. Playing in purely on just trying to get the group ready and then taking tomorrow off for the most part. Pretty unfortunate for the group, but he'll be there in the stands to be able to support us, and you know, who knows, by the end of the week, maybe he'll be able to go or contribute a little bit, but right now, I think we got a plan to just be ready to go without him. Either way, Leo's the kind of guy who will find a way to impact the game in some capacity while he supports his teammates. I'm pretty confident as a coach that we can win some games without Leo, you know, and anything can happen in any one game situation. So, we shall see.
got over it, and I was like, I'm gonna play regardless. And it just means too much for me and too much to everyone on the team for me not to be out there. And no, there was never really a thought in my mind that I wasn't gonna be there for these games.
Thank you.
There's nothing that I'm going to be able to say to you guys that's going to make you feel immediately better about the outcome of the game, okay? What I want you guys to know, from the bottom of my heart, I love coaching you guys. Every minute of it, man. Okay? It's tough to lose, okay? But there's nothing to be ashamed of. Okay, you guys have been an amazing team coach, okay? I don't cry. My wife came mad at me. She's like, you need to cry when you're upset with me. Okay, so I'm so proud of what you guys have done. Okay? Been through so much as a group, okay, from the minute you guys were freshmen, seniors, to tonight. Okay. Being down 11 in the fourth quarter, to be able to come back and do what you guys did shows so much character. Okay, so much grit. You guys believed from the very beginning of that game that we're gonna win. Okay, I don't think anybody in that gym except this group believed we were gonna win. Okay? So there's a lot to be proud of. Okay? Wins, losses, whatever, doesn't matter when it comes down to it. It's about the relationships in the room. Okay? That's one of my college teammates. I couldn't tell you how many games we won or lost. Couldn't tell you. But I know he gives a to them, come watch me coach high school basketball, right? And that's what it's going to be about when you guys are done, okay? When you guys aren't playing anymore, okay? That's what it's about, okay? It's going to hurt for a tick. Nothing you can do about that, okay? But when it's all said and done, okay, when you guys are out of here, we leave this locker room today, okay? It always stays the same. It's always about the family. It's always about the brotherhood, okay? And that will always be there. You're never going to lose that. Okay? You can lose a ball game. Okay? But you're not going to lose that. Okay? All right? Coaches, you guys got anything?
Proud of you guys, man. So your kids are coming to our school because they want to be like you. Our culture, like in our school, people think we're soft, right? There's nothing soft about what you guys did. Period. Point blank. Okay? Proud of you. You guys know you can pick up the phone anytime to hit a heads up. Young boys, right, we'll be back. Okay? I love you guys, man. Thank you for allowing us to coach you. Appreciate you.
Just because we were great, and, you know, I don't think that one loss on our season, we should just focus on that and take that away from how much we've accomplished as a group and how great we are as a team and how much of a family we are. I love you guys.
I really could not care less about if you guys make or miss shots, but the effort is literally the only thing that I care about. It's the only thing that I'm good at. And you guys put out so much effort that game. I'm so proud to be a part of a team like that. It's awesome. And I'm looking forward to watching you young guys continue with that same effort, win or lose. It's going to be fun to watch, and it's going to be fun to play like that. That's all you guys know.
Sort of. Thank each and every one of you guys, because when I walked into this gym 4 years ago, I had no idea just how much each of you would mean to me. And the real reason it really hurts right now is because, like, I know that's the last time I wore this Seattle Academy Cardinal jersey and be on the floor with you guys. But it was also, I'm so happy that you guys, you know, have been a part of my life.
It's been a hell of a ride, okay? It's been so fun, all right? And I know it sucks right now, but I don't know if there's been a more fun group of dudes to be around, okay? A more competitive group of dudes to be around on a regular basis, all right? Celebrate that, enjoy that, okay? Cool, let's go, Brandon, come on. There
we go.
SL 3 9 6 1 2 3 SL 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7
Your legacy is something you leave behind after you go through an experience with people. And the legacy that this group of boys, these families, these seniors, this team, the legacy that they're going to leave is something that's remarkable and something that's going to last for a really long time.